In the last video, we tried dn equal to 100 and it did not work. We tried dn equal to 100 and it did not work. Now let's say this value is 687. We need to make it 0, right? So we need to reduce this dn value at some point. So let's say dn equal to 74. Why I choose 74? Because I can just want to pass this neutral axis from the center of this top reinforcement. So let's say we pass this dn equal to 74, then we can just have this one equal to 0. So let's try that. So dn equal to 74. So in that case, compression force equal to 0 in this still, because if you substitute dn equal to 74, 74 take away 74, 0, 0 over something is 0, 0 times this value is 0. So the strain value is 0. If your strain value is 0 in the steel, top steels, then the stress equal to 0 and force equal to 0. So the force in the top steel equal to 0. Tensile force in the steel, because it's not depend on the dn, so we can just straight away take 600 kilonewton as we calculated before. So this top the force in the bottom reinforcement, the tensile force in the bottom reinforcement does not depend on this dn. It depend on dn. We need to make sure that it will yield it, but as we moving our neutral axis towards this top, then this will always going to yield. If you move your dn value towards this one, then it will not going to yield. We need to make a check. But if you are moving your dn value, the trial dl value is above or just reducing, then you are increasing this strain value here as is far from that one. So we can take this 600 kilonewtons. Concrete compressive strength, we done these calculations where we left the dn out. So in that case, you can just substitute dn 74, it gives me 814 kilonewtons. Now let's plus them all. CC, which is concrete compression force, 814. Force in the top steel is 0, and then tensile force is minus 600. It gives me 214. It was better. Now it's getting towards 0. 687.2 on the 100, and we get 74. It get 214. We need to go less down again. So let's put 60 millimeters. Okay, it could be 65. It could be 55, 50. I just tried this 60 millimeters. So again, we follow exactly the same procedures that we done. First, we calculate the strain in the top steel by just putting these equations. I think in this equation, we put dn equal to 60. So if you put that dn equal to 60 instead of 100, you will get this negative answers, right? Because now we are putting this dn is in this zone, meaning that this steel will be under the compressions. Now you can see that if I put the dn value 60, it's not 74, it's here. So then you get negative value. So negative value meaning that you have compressions, but don't worry, it's still not yielded because it's very small value, close to the neutral axis. So if not yielded, we can find the stress in the steels, like same procedures here, strain times Young modulus. This is a strain and it gives me minus 140. Then what is the force in the top steels? Then just stress times 1200 of area that are given here, stress times area. So my stress is minus 140 times 1200 equal to minus 168 kilonewton. Please note this minus, because now this is in the tension, because this is below the neutral axis. CT, it's not changing, because as we move the neutral axis towards the top, so your steel at the bottom is yielded, so you have 600 kilonewton. Concrete compression force is same equations, but instead of dn, we put 60 millimeters. Here we put 100, here we also put 74, now we're gonna put 60, so it gives me 660. Now if I substitute the values, 660, which is the concrete compression force, minus 168 for steel and minus 600 for tension steels equal to minus 108. Okay, that makes sense, because you have positive value. It was positive value at 74. It has negative value at 60. So it should be 0 is between these four. So we know that our neutral axis between 60 and 74. Let me put that one here. So 74 has that distance 74. We found 214. At 60, we found minus 100. So what dn value should give me? 0. So it's just a linear interpolation. 60 take away 74, minus 108 take away 214 equal to this. I put just x. I want to find this dn value. So x take away 74, 0 take away 214. So if I simplify that, this give me this value equal to x take away 74 over this value. If I simplify further, I can find this 0.025 times minus 214 equal to this x minus 74 minus 9.2 equal to x minus 74. X is equal to minus 9.2 plus 74 is give me x equal to 64.8. So this is the dn value that will give me the zero force. Now let's try whether it's give me the zero force or not. So dn equal to 64.8, again followed exactly the same procedures here. A strain in the top steel is equal to this equation, but instead of 60 we put 64.8. again 64.8 is sitting in this zone. You can see 64.8 is less than 74, so your steel, this one still in the tension, so we get negative value. Very small negative value is not yielded, so we need to find the stress in the steels. We follow exactly the same procedures here. So the strain times Young modulus gives me the stress in the top steel. Force in the top steel is just stress times area. We follow exactly the same here, and we got this tension force in the steels. And tension force in the bottom reinforcement, I think our neutral axis is far above this here, so this will be yielded. So 600 kilonewtons, it's not changing, so we put 600 kilonewtons here. Compression force in the concrete, we have these equations where we're going to put dn equal to 64.8, it gives me 713. Let's substitute all the values. 712, that was negative 102.2 tension force in the top reinforcement, and minus 609.8 kilonewton. It's almost zero. Someone will say, why are you not getting zero value? But because of this rounding of these numbers, it might give you this 9.8 kilonewtons, that is equal to zero. Now, once you found your neutral axis, then the procedure is simple. So the challenge is to find those neutral axis. Based on the neutral axis, we found all the forces. So let's draw this axis here. We saw this one in the previous video. Compression force in the concrete is 713 kilonewton. That's fine. The central, the distance from this compression force would be from the top is gamma dn over 2. Please check our previous videos where we look at that. I think we have calculated this gamma value. So gamma value was 0.87 times dn. This is new dn, 64.8 divided by 2. So 28.2, that's the distance, this 28.2. Now for this kind of pure, there is no axial force. It's a pure bending acting on the section. So the moment may be calculated about any point. So you can take any points here, any points here, any points here, anywhere you can take the moment, the answer would be same. In the previous videos, we are taking the moment about plastic center where you have this force acting. So axial force was acting, but here no axial force, so we can take the moment at any point. So let's take the moment about this point here, so we can eliminate this force. So let's say some of the force at the sum of the moment at this force CC equal to zero. Anticlockwise is positive. Let's denote this MUO, which is the pure bending. So 600, which is 600 times thousands convert into the newton, times by 526. I think if you know this 526, I can show it to you. I think we done this 526 many times. This one was 526. That 526 written here. So 526 take away this 28.2, that will give me this lever arm. So 526 take away 28.2 will give me this lever arm, plus 103.2, because this is anti-clockwise moment, this is also anti-clockwise moment, so that is plus, times by 1000 to convert into newton, times by 74. So this is 74, take away this 28.2, that will give me this lever arm. So that's simplifications gives me these numbers, divided by 1000, divided by thousands to get me in the kilonewton meters. So that is the pure bending. I think if I show you in my examples that we found this point, the axial force is zero, and this is the pure bending points. In the next video, as you can see, this is very tedious process. I will show you how you can develop the axial sheet to repeat to ease that kind of process. Thank you.